Hi guys, for this tutorial video, I'm gonna paint these frogs. This video I created to help one of my patron, which is Cathy. She showed me some of her painting, and then I realized that there's few area that she can improve. But it's difficult for me to explain through words. So I decided to make this video and to explain and demo the 3 points that could help her improve her painting. Alright, so the first point is when you paint in watercolor, try not to apply too many layers, because too many layers, you will become very messy, and it will destroy the fluidity of watercolor, which is the strength of watercolor compared to other medium, right? And then the second point is, you need to decide which direction is the light source from, right? Either it's from left top corner, right top corner, front or back. So you have to decide. But based on this picture of the frogs, the light source I can say that is from left top corner, right? So it's very important, because the light source will make your subject look 3D and real. Alright, this is the second point. The third point is try not to use lines to bring up the shape of the subject, right? Instead, you use a gradient or shape to bring out the edges. So all these 3 points, I will show it to you through this painting. Okay, for the first layer, I'm going to apply a very thin layer, and I want the bottom area here to be soft with maybe magenta. Okay, as you can see, the color is smudge, but it's okay because this is only the first layer. So not too worried about the smudging. Okay, because on the second layer, we're gonna bring out more edges with a thicker color, less water. Here. So our focus point is on this frog. So the rest of the object, like the lily pad and this umbrella, we are trying to do it less color and then not so detailed, so that the focus you always on the frog itself. All right. So the umbrella, I'm probably gonna use maybe blue and yellow, maybe, or gold. Okay, so I'd like to add in more color instead of just, you know, one, two color. It will make the painting richer. and I think I will kill these edges here because it's supposed to blend to the lily pad as a shadow. Right, so I'm gonna use a grayish color to create the shadow. Soften it with clear water to create a gradient. And I try to kill these edges here so that it won't be too obvious. Because I'm creating the depth, this area is actually further away. So that means that less detail is needed. Right, and so along the way I'll add more detail. Try to soften some of the edges. It's a little bit too sharp, the edges. Right, like here. When I do this, because it's wet, it will soften the layer below, and therefore the edges would be it will be removed. Okay. Like here as well, I don't like this to be too hard edges. Okay, I'll add a bit of pink over here. So the color I use, right, like this light pink, actually it merge with the magenta or the maroon color. So it doesn't it mix well with the magenta. Right. I want to soften some of the edges here as well. So will color here, and then soften it with clear water. Because it's a shadow. Again, try to soften the edges. I'm going to switch to the smallest brush for the detail. Okay, I think I'm going to use a bit of lemon white for the highlight. Because the gold color is not light enough, so I'm going to use. So right here, it is less water and more pigment or more color. All right, can you see? Right here. So when you do the highlight, remember where the light source is. So for our case, it's from the top left corner. It'll be a detail here. Okay, can you see that? So when I bring some of the color over here to here, it is more balanced, is it? Alright, let's soften the highlight on the eyeball that I mentioned just now. I think it'll be a bit too much, so I'm going to use clear water and remove some of the white. Yep, it's better now. Okay, yeah, I think it's quite enough. All right, Okay, so the last thing I need to do is to drop another layer of drip and splatter. This is to create the depth and the layer, and at the same time to have a sense of movement. It's like you are pumping oxygen into your painting, so it becomes more lively and not so still. Okay, for the drip, I need to use the biggest brush. I'm gonna drop some. Oh yeah, actually I forgot this area here, but I think it's not important actually. This leg here, you know. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna let it leave it out. I don't like all these hard edges. Too many hard edges. So I'm gonna drop some drip to have the different layer and try to kill some of the edges as well. Alright, and I'm gonna use some slightly darker color. Okay. Splatter. Okay, I'm gonna